Hi, everyone. My name is Sean, and welcome to the very first episode of The 101. A new series where we look to define endpoint security one question at a time. Security is complex. And in order for us to have a meaningful conversation about it, to help each other and to learn from one another, we need to have a common vocabulary. And that's precisely the goal of this series. We'll be looking at your questions week by week to help cut through the noise and get good definitions on core concepts and fundamental ideas. So join us as we dive into our very first question for this week, and it's one that I'm particularly excited about. What is a non-malware attack? I love this question. This term is rising in prominence, but it's still leaving so many of us scratching our heads looking for a clear definition. So let's start there. A non-malware attack is one in which an attacker manipulates existing software, allowed applications, and authorized protocols to carry out malicious activities. You see, non-malware attacks are capable of getting access to your machine without any malware at all, hence the name, non-malware. You may also hear non-malware attacks referred to as fileless, memory-based, and even living off the land. So why do we care about non-malware attacks? It's because they work. Keep in mind that for the past few decades, endpoint security has been focused on spotting and stopping malware, new files that are installed to carry out an attack. These defenses are singularly focused on stopping the bad stuff and letting everything else go through. And that's why non-malware attacks are so dangerous. It's also worth mentioning that non-malware attacks leave a very small footprint, making it even more difficult to spot. Okay, let's take a look at a quick example. So you're on your laptop, browsing the web, when unbeknownst to you, the website you're visiting has been compromised, and bam, you're hit by an opportunistic attack targeting Flash. Now, Flash is about as vulnerable as it gets, and unfortunately, your machine is no different. It wasn't up to date, and so the attack was successful, and the attacker now has access to your machine. But instead of installing new malware, the attacker instead invokes PowerShell, and they begin running scripts to do, well, anything, really. Establish remote connections, move laterally, maybe even dump hashes. The list goes on. So what are our key takeaways here? Well, your browser, Flash, PowerShell, these are all known, good, and in some cases, native applications running on your machine. If you were to look at each one of these individually, you would have no idea that something abnormal was happening at all. But therein lies the rub, and it's the key to stopping a non-malware attack. If you can analyze the event stream, you can uncover malicious intent, and you can stop an attack. But that's for another episode. That's it for this episode. Tune in next week as we continue to define endpoint security one question at a time. If you have questions, we want to hear about them. You can get them to us over Twitter, tweeting us at carbonblack_inc, using the hashtag the101, or email us at the101@carbonblack.com. You'll also find some pretty great resources down below, so don't forget to check that out before you leave. Thank you. We look forward to hearing from you, and we'll see you next week.